Hey everyone, welcome back to Stuti Studio. So I'm making this product for the National Itsy Bitsy contest. So I have already entered the contest and do vote for me. I have kept the link in the description below. Click the link, wait for a while and select my product by the name Stuti Studio and just fill up your name, contact number, email ID and submit. And also, if you like this video, do hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. So, let's go and see how I made it. The first product I'm using is this mirror, 9 to 9 inch in size. It has a protective layer on it, has to peel it off and use it. Next product is from Itsy Bitsy. This silver hoop, and it should be a little bit smaller than the mirror. Then this wooden beads and this little birdie macrame cords, 3-ply and 4mm in size. I just love this product. I will link everything on the description below. So, at first, I am going to cut 8 cords of 50 cm each, then fold them into half and attach them to the hoop one by one with a large head knot. Then separate the outer two cords like this and take the next 4 cord and make a square knot. There will be 3 square knots on the first row. On the second row, we will place a square knot just below the first 2 knots. And on the last row, there will be only 1 knot. Now this is how the square knots will look like. I'm quickly gonna fix the ring with this tape. It was a bit shaky. Then take this second cord, place it in a slanting way like this. Loop the cord with each cord twice. And when you reach on the middle, do the same with the other side as well. And same with the first cord also. And at last, this is how our pattern look like. Then we are going to attach 8 more cords on the sides like this and make a same new pattern. So keep doing it and fill up the whole ring with the same pattern. I made total 6 patterns. After a while, this is how our ring going to look like. Now you have to unwind the cords one by one like this. This process is going to kill your lots and lots of time. And after a while, it's gonna look like this. Looks a bit messy, right? Now take a comb and start brushing the cords like this. Again, this process is gonna take a lots and lots of time. Meanwhile, I have to fill up these gaps, and to do that, I'm going to attach a small cord and a bead like this. And tie a knot so that the bead won't come out. And continue unwinding the cords and attach one bead in every gap. Now this is the after brushing look of the frame. Now we will trim them in a petal like structure like this. Then attach a little longer cord here so that it can be hang somewhere. Now I'm going to spray some hairspray on it. While the cords are wet, brush them again and trim the extras. And now our frame is almost ready. Here comes our mirror. I'm attaching the mirror with a cardboard piece for extra security. The cardboard piece should be a little bit bigger than the mirror. Now attach the mirror to our beautiful frame, but first turn the frame upside down and with the help of a glue gun, attach it. I'm attaching one more cord to the back side of the mirror for extra security with the help of this glue gun. And it's all done. Our elegant mirror is all ready. Do let me know how much you like it and see you on my next video. Bye bye.